Hi, I'm Ken of Rist Innovations, and I scoured the YouTube universe for all the recommended 3D printed tools. And I have chosen the top 10 3D printed tools that are going to blow you away. I spent hours reviewing 3D printed tool recommendations before making my final selection. Some of the 3D printed tools are very simple and took me only 30 minutes to print, while others took many hours of 3D printing many parts, and then even more hours assembling the tools. In some cases, I added my own modifications to make the 3D printed tools even better, so you don't want to miss my tips. I think you're going to want to 3D print every one of these tools for your workshop. So let's get started. The following list is not in any particular order of importance or complexity, so you're going to want to see all 10 of the 3D printed tools to see which one is your favorite. I have saved my favorite one for last. Let me know in the comments which one is your favorite. The links for all the 3D printed tool files are in the description below. Number 1. Modular Corner Radius Template Set. You've probably seen some of the other radius corner template sets before that allow you to clamp 3D printed corner templates of different radii, but this set from Alexandria Chapel has a unique feature that I haven't seen anywhere else. By the way, he has a great YouTube channel at A Chapel. On most corner templates, you need to use adjustable clamps to hold the template to the workpiece, but the clamps can get in the way of the router. Alexandre's solution is designing a slot in the template so you can use these special clamps that fit into the slot so the template is completely clear of any clamps for the router. I normally use a jigsaw to remove most of the material. Then I use the router. The template works great. Alexandre has two sets of radius templates, one from 5mm to 8mm and a larger set from 85mm to 160mm. He even designed a clever storage rack that mounts on the wall. In my case, I added a French cleat, so I mounted my rack to my French cleat wall. I've only printed the small set of templates, but eventually I'll print the larger radius templates so I have the full collection. His YouTube channel and to his store are in the description below. The digital files for his corner radius template set cost $10. If you are working on a prototype project and you need some help, I have the answer for you. This brings me to the sponsor of today's video, PCB Way. If you're working on any prototype projects, they can help you when you need a variety of parts. Besides making PCBs, they also offer CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, injection molding, and lots of different types of 3D printing, including metal printing. You just need to go on their website, upload your design, select the material and the quantity you need, and you'll get an instant quote. Then they'll manufacture the parts and ship them right to your door. Give them a try, and I think you'll be amazed at what they can do for you. Check out PCB Way using the link below. Number 2, automated filament spool rewinder. I originally built this automated filament spool rewinder so that I could rewind non-Bamboo Lab filament onto Bamboo Lab spools so they would fit into the Bamboo Lab AMS, which is the automated material system unit. The original design is by Mikos Kazesli and two remixes by Bird to Brain and Diplomator, all on printables. In my last video, I reviewed the new Sunlu filament connector, which allows you to easily splice filaments together. So I can use this spool rewinder to consolidate my partial spools for my printers that don't have the AMS unit. The reason I mentioned the AMS unit is that it has a feature to automatically switch to the next similar spool when you run out of the primary spool. I cover my build of the automated filament spool rewinder in another of my videos titled The 10 Best Upgrades for Your Bamboo Lab 3D Printer, and that link is in the description below. Number 3, screw gauges. These screw gauges are great for measuring the diameter and length of machine screws. I printed this metric one from the preloaded files when I received my Bamboo Lab X1 carbon printer. I found this imperial screw gauge from EMX on Thingiverse, and each one takes about 90 minutes to print. Number 4, Router Table Center Finder. This Router Table Center Finder is a unique tool designed by Darren at Darren's Workshop, and he has a YouTube channel at Darren's Workshop. This tool allows you to cut a channel directly in the center of a piece of wood on your router table. Just mount the jig onto the 1/4-inch diameter router bit and then place your workpiece on the bracket. Then bring the fence forward until it touches the jig on one end and the workpiece on the other end, and then lock down the fence. Then cut your slot into your workpiece. This takes about 60 minutes to print, and the digital files are on Colts 3D for a cost of only $1.36. Number 5, lead screw brush cleaner. This lead screw brush cleaner, designed by Adam L. on MakerWorld, is a very effective way to clean the lead screws of the Bamboo Lab printers. It's just a matter of printing out the part and gluing an old toothbrush head on the end. There are threads on the inside of the part that match the threads on the lead screws. So you just have to squeeze the bristles into the lead screws and operate the build plate up and down. The bristles get deep into the grooves of the threads and do a great job in cleaning the threads. It only took less than 30 minutes to print out this part. Number 6, threaded insert machine. This threaded insert machine was designed by Iconic Fab, and they're on Printables. And I bought the mechanical parts from dfh.fm. The STL files are free, and the mechanical kit is on sale for $36.99. I 3D printed the parts using Bamboo Lab ABS, and things went together pretty smoothly. The key feature of the insert machine is the linear rail and this retractable key box. Overall, the Iconic Fab assembly instructions were very complete. The only part that wasn't clearly documented was attaching the retractable key box assembly to the machine. I removed the belt clip and the key ring, and then I attached the key box to the press. Then I extended the cable and hooked the end to the arm, then attached the arm to the linear rail. I would have preferred a digital soldering iron versus the analog one that came with my kit. However, it appears now that dfh.fm is providing the digital soldering iron in their kits. Here I am making a heat press to make another heat press. So this is just blowing my mind. Number 7, radius finder. These simple inside and outside radius finders by Victor NPB on Printables are great for reverse engineering real world objects so you can quickly measure a radius for your designs. Number 8, tapping arm. This clever tapping arm was designed by Chris Borg at Chris Borg on Printables. He has a great YouTube channel at Borg Designs with an assembly video on the tapping arm. I 3D printed the parts in Bamboo Lab PLA, and I filled it with mortar per Chris's instructions. The mortar really makes this a beefy tool that allows you to easily hold your workpiece with the vise and tap your holes to create threaded holes. The vise keeps your taps perpendicular to the hole, and the counterweight allows for a smooth, reliable operation. For some reason, the counterweight 3D printed parts were not on the Printables download files, so I designed my own counterweight assembly and filled it with lead shot. Number 9, drill guide. This drill guide is another well-designed product by USSA Design. He has a great YouTube channel at USA Design that combines many 3D printed parts and woodworking to create many different products. What I liked about this drill guide is it allows you to drill holes perpendicular to your workpiece using a portable drill. This is especially useful for your workpieces that you could not fit onto a drill press. The guide rails also offer repeatable positioning for drilling multiple holes. It also has a tilting feature that allows you to adjust the angle of holes from 90 degrees to 75 degrees in 1-degree increments. The laser feature is especially useful, but I couldn't find a small enough laser, so I bought this one online and I drilled out a larger hole in the laser holder so that it would fit. I will eventually design my own adapter to fit my laser. He even has alternate designs to drill holes in a variety of work pieces, as seen in this excerpt of his YouTube video. I purchased the digital files for the drill guide on his website for $20. And number 10, ball vise. This ball vise is my favorite 3D printed tool because it is so versatile. This design by Chris Borg again at Chris Borg and Printables, is the same guy who designed the tapping arm I spoke about a few minutes ago. I 3D printed the combination of Chris's original ball vise design and his updated extra large base design, which offers many improvements. Just like the tapping arm, I filled the ball and base with mortar. To add even more weight to the ball, I mixed in a pound of lead shot into the mortar. I also attached a magnetic base LED light using a couple of fender washers, and I bought a magnifying glass with a light combo unit to also improve the features. At Chris's suggestion, I also printed this circuit board holder designed by Squin at Squin on Printables. I also printed the factorial vise and the regular vise, which are great because they are interchangeable with the ball vise and the tapping arm. The ball vise is adjustable to any angle and it stays in place due to its weight and this rubber ring. The vise rotates 360 degrees using this precise bearing and it's lockable using this pin. Chris has two assembly YouTube videos on this design, which are in the description below. I'm really happy to add this ball vise to my workshop, and I recommend you consider doing the same for yours. And number 11. As an added bonus for you today, I have another product from USSA Design. It's a height marker for furniture designs. This is a simple but clever way to draw horizontal lines on furniture workpieces. The digital files cost $3 on USSA's online store, and the link is in the description below. If you found this video useful, I would really appreciate it if you would hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, let me know in the comments below which is your favorite. Do you have some other favorite 3D printed tools that I didn't mention? Let me know that too. Thanks for watching. Bye.